about in Babel of 1732. That is when King George II of England was granted a charter for this colony. King George II of England granted a charter for this colony to our founder, James Edward Oglethorpe. Now, Oglethorpe would handpick the people he brought over to start the 13th final colony. He didn't just bring anybody. It would take him about 3 months to make this voyage. They set sail in November of 1732. Landed about a half a mile left of us here to the north on a little place called the Yamacraw Bluff. Yamacraw Bluff was home to the Yamacraw Indians. They were led by a great man named Chief Comanche. Comanche welcomed these new settlers along with Oglethorpe, and he was a big help while Oglethorpe laid out this beautiful city. They became really close friends. And there's still people today that still try to give Comanche credit as being the co-founder here in Georgia. But Oglethorpe came here, his main reason was to make this colony a military buffer between South Carolina to the north and Florida to the south. Everyone was scared that the Spanish from Florida would invade South Carolina. Oglethorpe was not about to let that happen. Another reason he came here, believe it or not, is the dome of this weather. Now, it gets powerful hot here in the summer, but our winters are really mild. So here he grows a good crop. Our most successful crops back in the 1700s and 1800s were peaches and cotton. And that is, we are still called the Peach State here in Georgia today. A little misleading though, because South Carolina still produces more than twice the peaches as we do here in Georgia today. But we are still called the Peach State. But Oglethorpe had it all planned out before he got here. He had this big grid pattern drawn out. Inside that grid, he included 24 squares. We still have 22 of these squares remaining. We're going to see quite a few of these squares. We lost one here to the left. This used to be Liberty Square. It's kind of funny it was called Liberty Square because for 60 years we had the Savannah Jailhouse was here on Liberty Square. It was just torn down a couple of years ago. They haven't told us yet what they're going to build here. Another square that we lost, right over here to the right, Elbert Square. This today is home to our Savannah Civic Center. This is our concert hall here. We got two venues on the south end, on the other end, a big arena named for Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the civil rights leader from Georgia. Here on the north end, a theater named for Johnny Mercer. Johnny Mercer, great lyricist and songwriter from right here in Savannah, wrote the words to about 1,600 songs. He wrote, "You Must Have Been a Beautiful Baby." He wrote "Moon River" for the great movie Breakfast at Tiffany's. We do get some great shows here at our Civic Center today. Not before all this broke out, the Grand Supreme was here not long ago. Miss Diana Ross, that great comedian, Tater Savage, Ron White, he was just here recently. So we get some good shows here. And if any of you ladies were Girl Scouts, you should recognize the name of this lady coming up here to your left. This is the first federal building to ever be named for a lady, and we call her the original J-Lo here in Savannah. This is Juliet Gordon Lowe. She founded the Girl Scouts of America right here in Savannah back in 1912. Now, Juliet Gordon Lowe lived a pretty charmed life. The Gordon family, very wealthy. Her granddad started our Central of Georgia Railroad that brought all of that cotton here into Savannah. Then she married even more money when she married into the Andrew Lowe family. Andrew Lowe was the wealthiest man in town. He was the king of cotton. We got some great churches here in Savannah. Here's one of the finer ones right here. This is our independent Presbyterian church. And this is the mother of Presbyterian churches here in Georgia. This congregation dates back to 1755. Beautiful sanctuary was built here in 1888. The original had burned to the ground just 2 years earlier in 1886. But then a fine lady from here in Savannah would give the property for this sanctuary to the congregation. A lady named Mary Telford. You're going to hear that name quite a few times today. She did a lot for this beautiful city. We're coming up here. This is going to be our first stop. Stop number two. Get a good look at this steeple right here. This is the most popular steeple in Savannah. And also the tallest. 228 feet tall. But this is our stop number two on your map, folks. Independent Presbyterian.
People coming on, maybe.